even the smallest of critters can cause big problems for the adventurers in Warhammer Quest Cursed City. Welcome to this video where we're going to show you how you can paint your bats and rat swarms from the box set. Now you'll notice straight away that both models have been undercoated here with Chaos Black Spray. It's the perfect colour to use for the colour schemes we're going to be painting them in. Let's have a look first at the scuttling rat swarms. Now for these I want to make them look a bit varied, so I'm going to be using some browns and some blacks to pick out different rats. First of all, let's start off with a dry brush of Eschen Grey over the entire base, here using a medium dry brush. Let's take some Eschen Grey here from the pot and onto a piece of tissue paper I've got prepared. Now what I'm going to do here is make sure that all the paint has been carefully worked out into the tissue paper here, leaving just the tiniest amount on the brush. There we go, really get into that bristles there. Perfect. Now onto the rat swarm. Here we're lightly dry brushing this over the entire model like so, from front to back. Just make sure we're picking out some of the raised areas on the rats. Now it's important here to be as light and careful as you possibly can be with your dry brush. Don't dry brush too hard, you might break the tails off the rats. There we go, that's our first colour painted. Now up next, let's add a bit of variety to that base of rats by adding in some base coats. Now first of all, I'll base coat some of the rats with Dryad Bark. Then I'll pick out some more of the rats with Monfang Brown. Then I'm going to pick out all the tails with Cadian Flesh Tone, and finally the skulls and any exposed bone with Wraithbone. First of all, it's that Dryad Bark, and for this I've got my small base brush. Let's take some Dryad Bark here from the pot and onto the palette here. Now as this is a base paint, I'm going to add a little bit of water just to help thin it down to make sure it goes on real smooth. Perfect. Then onto our rat swarm. Now what I'm doing here is just picking out a few of the rats here and there. It's entirely up to you which ones want to be what colour. I'm going to leave most of them on the base as black, but here I'm going to pick up this one here with the Dryad Bark. I'm going to be painting the entire rat, basically its feet and body, but not the tail, with this colour. If your rat's got an exposed skull, like this one has here, we'll paint that in a second. Next up, I've got Monfang Brown, and here again I pick out some of the rats here and there. I'm going to start with this big one at the top because I fancy him being lighter brown. But again, it's entirely up to you. Just pick out a few of the rats to your choosing in this lighter colour. Next up, I've got Cadian Flesh Tone. Here I've switched over to my medium layer brush for a bit more control. Now I'm going to carefully peck out all of the rats' tails like this. Now take your time here, there's quite a few tails on this base. Just be as neat as you possibly can and try not to hit any of the parts of the bodies we've already painted. But if you do, don't worry, just go back and correct it with the paint we've just used. Up next, I've got Wraithbone. And here I'm picking out some of the exposed skulls on some of these rats, and also any teeth that are sticking out as well. So you can see a big skull here on this rat. This one in the middle here, just going to paint that up right now. This one's got a skull here as well. Just go around and pick out all the teeth and any exposed bones and skulls on all your rats. So there we go, that's all the base coats applied onto our rat swarm. Now up next, let's apply a wash. Here we'll be using Agrax Earthshade, and for this I've got my medium layer brush for a bit more control. Let's take some Agrax Earthshade here and apply it to our palette. Now we're not going to thin this down at all, but we are going to make sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint. There we go, just the right amount. There we go. Now onto our rat swarm. Here we're applying this wash all over the entire base, apart from the black fur of the black rats. So it's going over the brown fur, the flesh of the tails, and the bone as well. Everywhere that's not black fur, paint this wash on right now. If you do hit the black fur, it's not the end of the world. We'll just have a slightly browny looking rat, and that's no problem at all. There we go, the wash is dry and our rat pack is already looking disgusting. Perfect. All right, up next, we're going to add some highlights onto our rats to help define them and pick out the individual rats. Now, you could dry brush these on if you want to be nice and quick, but I'm going to be using highlighting here for a bit more neatness. Now, first of all, I'm going to take Dawnstone and highlight the black rats. Then I'll take Gorthor Brown and highlight the dark brown rats. Deathclaw Brown will be used to highlight the light brown rats. Then we'll use Kislev Flesh on the tails before finally picking out their beady little eyes with Mephiston Red. First of all, it's time for that Dawnstone highlight. I've got my small airbrush for this. Let's grab some paint here from the pot and onto our palette. Now, to make sure we get a nice smooth highlight, we're adding a little bit of water here to thin that paint down and making sure we've got a nice point on the brush. There we go. Then onto our rat swarm. Here, we're going to find one of our black rats. There's one at the back there. I'm just going to add a very, very cheeky highlight here. Just a subtle one, just on the absolute raised parts. You don't have to highlight every part of the rat. Just largest muscles like this on the hind legs here, for example. There we go, we'll put one around the face as well. You can choose to pick out as many highlights as you like on your rat, it's entirely up to you. And don't forget, if you want to speed the process up, you could dry brush these on instead. Then I've got Gorthor Brown. Just the same again here on the dark brown rats. So a nice fine highlight here on the darkest brown rats, just picking out the bits here and there we want to pick out. You don't have to highlight the whole rat again, just entirely up to you. Then Deathclaw Brown, and here we're using it to pick out the highlights on the lighter brown rats that we undercoated with Mournfang Brown earlier on. Again, just picking out selected highlights here and there. On the larger rats, like the one in the centre, it's a good idea to do quite a few highlights to help really make that stand out. Next up, I've got Kislev Flesh, and here, just on the absolute tips of the tails, just a cheeky little highlight that list, just to help define them. With that done, now I've got some Mephiston Red and a small airbrush, and very carefully we'll pick out the eyes on our rats. And there we go, with that our rat swarm is complete. Now let's have a look at painting the bats. And here again we've started with the Chaos Black undercoat, and over the top of that we're going to be placing three dry brushes on the model. First of all, Corvus Black, then Eshin Grey, and then Dawnstone. Let's start off with Corvus Black, and for this I've got my medium dry brush again. Let's take some paint from the pot, and again onto a piece of tissue paper. Here we're working those bristles into the tissue paper to make sure there's very little paint left on the brush, just a tiny little amount. Perfect. Then onto our bat swarm. Now here we've got the largest bat, but this will work on all the bats as well. We're just going to be dry brushing this Corvus Black all over the entire model. So just picking out the wings, the face, the flesh, all of it like this. Now be very careful when you're dry brushing with this large brush. You don't want to break this bat off of its stand or knock its head off, especially with the smaller bats on the sides as well. Just be super careful, nice and light. Just make sure you're picking out those raised areas. Then it's another dry brush, this time of Eshin Grey, so it'll be a nice lighter dry brush over the top here. We're just concentrating really on the ridged areas of the wings and the raised parts of the bat here. Just working our way around the whole model with the Eshin Grey. Then one more dry brush of Dawnstone, here making sure picking out all the ribbed parts of the wings. There we go, that's the dry brushes done. Now let's add a bit of colour onto the model here by using a contrast paint, Volupus Pink, to add on some fleshy bits around the wings and body. Grab a medium layer brush for this. Now we've got some Volupus Pink here, I'm going to take it onto our palette. I'm not going to thin this down at all, we're just going to make sure we've not got too much paint though on the brush. Perfect amounts. Then onto our bat swarm. Here what we're doing is we're picking out all the ridges and parts of the bat like this on the arm. So we're just picking out, here we go, just working our way around with the Volupus Pink, picking out these ridges like this to give a bit of an extra colour to the model. There we go, that's the Volupus Pink painted onto the wings. You can see the difference it makes. That's a nice bit of colour there. All right, up next, let's add some more colour here by painting some of the fleshy areas you see on the bats. We'll start off with a base coat of Bugman's Glow, then move on to put a layer over the top of Cadian Flesh Tone for highlighting with Kislev Flesh. Let's grab some Bugman's Glow first of all. Got my medium layer brush for this. There we go, let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now, as always with the base paint, I'm going to thin it down to make sure it goes on real smooth. Don't need too much there at all. Bingo. Then onto our bat. Now, here we're picking out the fleshy areas on the model. And if you have a look at the pictures of the bats that come with Warhammer Quest Cursed City, you'll see that on the face, they've got a fleshy area here and around the ears, just like this. Then we've got some Cadian Flesh Tone. And here we're applying it over the top of the Bugman's Glow as a layer. So we're just leaving the original colour in the recesses like so, and just picking out the raised parts like this to get that sort of layered effect on the face. Then finally, I've got some Kislev Flesh here with a small airbrush, just to add tiny highlights here and there to the absolute raised parts of our bat's face. There we go, that's the fleshy parts done. All right, let's finish off the bat next by picking out the claws and teeth. First with a base coat of Abaddon Black and then a highlight of a Shabti Bone. When that's done, we'll pick out the eyes and tongue of our bat with Mephiston Red. Grab your small airbrush for this first base coat. Let's take some Abaddon Black from the pot here and onto our palette. We're making sure we're keeping a nice fine point on that brush, and we're also getting a little bit of water to help thin it down. Then onto our bat. So here we go. We're painting this now onto the teeth and claws of our bat. Working our way around and just finding anywhere where we have teeth or claws, just paint it right now with this base coat. Then we've got a Shabti Bone, and here we're using it as a highlight on the claws and teeth, so it's going to be painting the edges like so to make it look like a nice sharp claw. Do the same over that side as well, just on the edge like that. Pick out the teeth as well. Just be really careful here. You can use the edge of the brush to make sure you're just picking out the absolute tips of the teeth like this. Then, very carefully with Mephiston Red, I'm just going to pick out the tongue, which is just that little bit sticking out of the front there, and also the eyes. Now to do this, brace your hand up against your paint handle and just very carefully dot the eyes in with red, just like that. There we go, with our eyes and tongue painted in, our bat is done and ready for you to finish the base. And there we go, that's how you can paint your rat swarms and bat swarms for your games of Warhammer Quest Cursed City. Hope you enjoyed this video. Happy painting.